This is Injustices number 7, but I don't know which version of Injustices it is, because the other comic I did was also number 7. Up front, I didn't like these Injustices comics, and this is the only other issue I've actually got. And I'll start by saying that this is much better than the other one. There are still a lot of problems, like all the characters are bad one-dimensional iterations. And this one, it has got art by that disgraceful creature, Mike Smiller. So this is all probably Ringus's original art that he has just drawn on top of. But one of the improvements is that this is much better as an issue. It is a single story and it's got a clear focus. It's not a bunch of random sequences stapled together. This one, it's all about Robert, the Darnell Wayne version, Batman's son. Or rather, this one-note version who's just an angsty prat who's having a whiny temper tantrum non-stop. We start off with a scene with him and Jarvis, then we cut to Catwoman and Harlequin. I've no idea what the current setup or storylines are for all these characters, but this is the annoying Harlequin, who's just a bad dead pills. And of course, because they are girls, they are best friends. And Robert, he shows up to capture them. And I think Robert, he's a bit grumpy because he was responsible for the death of the original Robert, Nightbird. And that's like the bulk of his characterization. I didn't like it. I think it's a really flat and lazy take on Darnell Wayne to just make him into like the emo kid with daddy issues. But I do respect that this is just a better written comic and a much better presentation than the other one. This one, it's not written by Down Under Taylor, which is probably why it's a bit better. But I didn't feel that this story does a great job of showcasing what it thinks it is showcasing. We're meant to be exploring Robert and having him accept or deal with his baggage and resolve some of his issues, but it really doesn't do that much for showing any of that. We just have him confront a bunch of villains, and these encounters at most make some vague lip service to the idea that Darnell is having a bit of an identity crisis. And he's trying to disassociate from Batman. But it's also a really badly done idea, because all that's really happening is he is replacing Batman with Superman. And he's become the equivalent of Superman's sidekick instead. So he is fighting some villains and some who are not villains, like Tiger Stripe. And I want to like this issue because, well, it's just written better than the other issues I've seen. But I also didn't think it's very successful at what it is trying to do. And then the Casper of the original Robert, Nightbird, he shows up and he's apparently like dead boy now. And he saves Darnell. And then the big ending is Darnell decides to become the new Nightbird. And this is meant to be like a big character moment with him dealing with his culpability in the death of Nightbird. But it's all hollow. It doesn't actually resolve anything or show any actual character growth. It's just him putting on a new costume and then Superman saying he's proud of him. I will say the cover is pretty good. It reflects the interior content quite well, but I just didn't feel like this is a finished story. It feels more like a plot summary rather than a script or a comic. It's much better than the other Injustices comics, but no, I didn't recommend it. It's only getting are 7 thumbs up.